Hello there, my name's Nicola and I'm one of the dietitians here at Coeliac UK. So today we're going to talk a little bit about celiac disease. So 1 in 100 people have celiac disease here in the UK, but we know that only 30% of people with celiac disease are actually diagnosed. So there are many people with the symptoms who remain undiagnosed. Twice as many women as men have celiac disease. And we know that risk increases to 1 in 10 for people with a close first degree relative. So that would be a parent, a sibling, or child with celiac disease. So what is celiac disease? Celiac disease is a lifelong autoimmune disease. It is not an allergy or an intolerance. In celiac disease, the body attacks its own tissues when you eat gluten, and this causes damage to the lining of the gut. So you can see from the images on the screen in front of you, the top image is a healthy gut, and you can see these finger-like projections called villi, which help to increase the surface area of the gut and help us to absorb nutrients such as vitamins and minerals from the foods and the drinks that we're eating. But in celiac disease, gluten causes damage to the lining of the gut, and these villi, these finger-like projections, become shortened or eroded away completely. We know that the body can react to tiny amounts of gluten. Antibodies are part of the immune system, and they normally react to bacteria and viruses and help us to fight against infection. But in celiac disease, these antibodies react to gluten and attack the body. The antibodies react to even tiny amounts of gluten. So if you are diagnosed with celiac disease, it is really important that you follow a strict gluten-free diet for life. As I'm sure you're all aware, there are a wide variety of different symptoms in celiac disease. The most common tend to be gut symptoms, so any wind, bloating, constipation, or diarrhea. But other symptoms include feeling tired all the time, anemia, nausea and vomiting, weight loss, mouth ulcers, and in some cases, dermatitis herpetiformis. Dermatitis herpetiformis, or DH, is the skin manifestation of celiac disease. It's less common than celiac disease, affecting only around 1 in 3,300 people. And it tends to appear as red raised patches that can really itch, can sting and can blister. It usually occurs on elbows, knees, shoulders, buttocks and face, but it can occur anywhere on the body. So for diagnosis of celiac disease, we know that gluten must be in the diet in more than one meal every day for at least 6 weeks before testing or until your diagnosis is confirmed by your gastroenterologist. The first step in diagnosis is to have a blood test to look for antibodies. Some people might be able to be diagnosed by blood tests alone, but others will need to have an endoscopy and a biopsy to look for damage to the lining of the gut. So why is a gluten-free diet important? If you're diagnosed with celiac disease or DH, we know that following a gluten-free diet helps to improve your symptoms. It also allows your gut to heal and those villi, the finger-like projections, to grow back again. Allows the body to absorb nutrients, so vitamins and minerals, from the foods and drinks that you're consuming. And it also helps to reduce your long-term risk of complications, such as osteoporosis, fertility problems, neurological conditions, nutritional deficiencies, and in very rare cases, lymphoma and cancer of the small bowel. So after diagnosis, what care should you expect? The National Institute for Health and Care Excellence guideline on the recognition, assessment and management of celiac disease recommends that after diagnosis, you have an appointment with a dietitian to go through the gluten-free diet with you. This could be a one-to-one appointment or a group session. Once you've been on the gluten-free diet for some time, it's also recommended that you have a yearly checkup, and that could be either with your GP, a dietitian, a pharmacist, a specialist nurse, or a gastroenterologist. If you haven't been seen by a healthcare professional for your celiac disease recently, speak to your GP. Vaccinations. So we know that the spleen is an important part of the immune system, and if it doesn't work properly, it can lead to an increased risk of infection. Some adults with celiac disease have a reduced spleen function, and for this reason, certain vaccinations are recommended. It's recommended that you have vaccination against pneumococcal infection with a booster every 5 years. It's also recommended that you have the annual flu vaccination. And for anyone who was born between 1995 and 2014, it's recommended you have the meningococcal A, C, W, and Y vaccine. For more information on vaccinations, you can visit our website, or for individual advice, we'd recommend speaking to your own GP. Here at Coeliac UK, we know what it takes to live gluten-free every day. And if whether you're an adult with celiac disease, or you have a child, or you're caring for someone living gluten-free, our resources are here to help you every day for every occasion. Our range of membership features include our welcome pack to help you get started on your gluten-free diet, our printed food and drink guide, our gluten-free checklist, and a fact sheet about celiac disease. We also have our helpline supported by myself and my colleagues, Lorna and Naomi, as well as our food advisors to answer all your diet and health questions. We have our essential food information service, which lists over 150,000 products that are suitable for a gluten-free diet. And we've made food shopping easy with our award-winning gluten-free food checker app. Our community networks are there so you can share your experiences with people just like you. And we also have our flagship magazine, Live Well Gluten-Free, which is sent out to you twice a year. As well as all that, we have exclusive offers and discounts saving you up to £200 a year. So wherever you are in your gluten-free journey, our community is the place to be. So for more information about joining, you can see our website. We have a range of different packages available from just £1.25 per month. And these will provide you with those exclusive member resources to help you live well gluten-free. So in summary, celiac disease is a lifelong autoimmune condition. It is not an allergy or an intolerance. It affects around 1 in 100 people in the UK, but many people are undiagnosed. Diagnosis will usually involve endoscopy with biopsy to look at the damage to the lining of the gut. But the first step in getting diagnosed is speaking to your GP about having a blood test. If you're diagnosed with celiac disease, the only treatment is a lifelong, strict gluten-free diet. Next, you can watch our presentation on the gluten-free diet.